The same pandemic that caused video game sales to soar has put arcades on the brink of bankruptcy.
And the issue isn't just the customers aren't around to play the games, is that the games are there in the first place.
Denver 7's Jessica Porter explains.
Customers used to enter these doors and be greeted with the sounds of drinks clicking, arcade buttons smashing, and the cheer after a round one at pool. But today, silence.
We're directly tied with the restaurants and the bars, you know, and so, I mean, when they're closed down, we're closed down.
Indoor dining is restricted, and that means business for Colorado amusement operators is dead. Their games, now just a convenient place for storage.
You know, that's a $7,000 air hockey table sitting there, and it hasn't generated any income since March.
Most restaurants and bars don't own the games at their locations. Vendors like Paradise Pinball and Amusements operate and maintain them. Only three of Burnham's 45 locations in Colorado are open.
A lot of our locations have actually started cutting down on the size of their game rooms because they need those table spaces at 25% occupancy.
Basically, it's an ecosystem. One cannot survive without the other.
Restaurants not only split the gaming profits, but benefit from increased sales.
That definitely extends the time that they're here. It extends the alcohol sales, the food sales.
Amusement operators are asking lawmakers to give them a chance to survive by loosening restrictions.
Allow more people to come in. I mean, we're taking the necessary precautions. We've been, you know, the locations that we have, we're cleaning games regularly.
Burnham cut staff down from 7 to 2.5. But this could soon be game over for an industry that created so many memories.
If they're going to keep us closed down, I mean, you got to help us out a little bit or you're going to lose us. You know, I mean, the entertainment side of this industry could be gone forever.
Jessica Porter, Denver 7.